اسم مجرور. الله is a noun. You understand what I'm saying? Because Allah Azza wa Jalla is not. So the scholars say you call that particular Allah Lafdhul Jalala. Lafdhul Jalala. Lafd يعني the term. Jalala is honor. So you are referring to the term Allah. But you will not be using it specifically in order not to put it in the grammar, and that may be يعني degrading. It might not be appropriate to say Allah is a, you know, verb, or Allah is a noun, and what have you, because Allah is Allah. But the term, the name Allah is a noun. So you call it Lafdhul Jalala. Ilmun alamun ala nafsi Allah Azza wa Jal. It is a noun, proper noun, about referring to Allah Azza wa Jal himself. وَلَا يُسَمَّ بِهِ غَيْرُهُ. And no one else, no one can be given that particular name. وَمَعْنَاهَ الْمَأْلُوهُ. And what is meant by that term? الْمَأْلُوهُ meaning the one whom is looked at as a god. مَأْلُوهُ from إِلَهِ. إِلَهِ is God. The one whom the people treat as a god. This is what is intended by that. أي الْمَعْبُودُ مَحَبَّةً وَتَعْظِيمًا. Meaning the one who is worshipped in love and magnifying. The one who is worshipped in love and magnifying. وَهُوَ مُشْتَقٌ عَلَى الْقَوْلِ الرَّاجِحِ لِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ. And they say that it is derived from the verse, and it is Allah, He is Allah in the heavens and in the earth. He knows what you conceal and what you reveal. Now of course when we say that Allah is in the earth, we do not mean that He is mixed with His creation. Rather, He is the one who is worshipped in the heavens and the one who is worshipped in the earth. Not that Allah Azza wa Jalla Himself is in the earth. Remember we discussed this, that Allah is above His creation, above the seven heavens. He does not mix and match with them. He does not mix with His creation here. Whomever thinks so need to change his understanding. According to the four a'immah, according to Imam Abu Hanifa, you may go outside of Islam if you deny that Allah is above His creation. So here the Allah, وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ, meaning He is the one who is worshipped in love and magnifying by the inhabitants of the heavens like the angels and the inhabitants of the earth like us and the jinn. طيب طيب فإن في السماوات متعلق بلفظ الجلالة يعني وهو المألوه في السماوات وفي الأرض. This is what I mentioned right now. الرحمن فهو ذو الرحمة الواسعة لأن فعلان في اللغة العربية تدل على السعة والامتلاء كما يقال رجل غضبان إذا امتلأ غضبا. الرحمن meaning he is the one full of mercy, comprehensible mercy. طيب أن الله عز وجل has the ultimate mercy. And because in the Arabic language the words come in a certain fashion, like على وزن فعل وفاعل مفعول وإلى آخره. So among them is فعلان, whatever sounds like فعلان, رحمن, and as he mentioned here, غضبان, someone, that method of presenting the word in Arabic indicates excessiveness and abundance. So when you say رجل غضبان, meaning he is full of غضب, he is full of anger. So you use the way it is said, it ends with ألف نون, غضبان, على وزن فعلان. Likewise, Rahman, meaning full of mercy, abundance of mercy. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Ar-Rahim, ismun yadullu ala al-fi'l. Ar-Rahim is a noun which indicates action, the action of mercy. لأن فعيل بمعنى فعل فهو دل على الفعل. So here, it means mercy for the believers. Of course, you know from the tafsir of Fatiha, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the scholars say Ar-Rahman, this is general mercy that encompasses all the creation, believers and disbelievers. Whereas Ar-Rahim is particular and specific to the believers. Because Allah says in another verse, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. And He is to the believers merciful with the way it is said is Rahim. So that Rahim is specific for the believers, those who believe and will enter Jannah. Versus the Rahman, which encompasses all of the creation, even the kuffar, who, يعني, justice, Allah's justice is there with them, and Allah Azza wa Jal, with justice He treats them, and yet they are still under His mercy. You know what I'm saying? And the mercy is there. Otherwise, justice only will require that these people will be off earth, removed off the planet. Because all they do is cause corruption upon earth. They disbelieve in God. They have nullified the purpose of creation, which is what they're supposed to do. They go against the teachings of the messengers and the prophets, and they just follow their desires and they just want to make money. Yani Allah musta'an. But Allah is merciful, even to them. But on the day of judgment, they will be deprived. They will be deprived of the mercy that will be a source of safety for them. They got it here, but it doesn't mean they will get it there, unless they repent to Allah. فيجتمع من الرحمن الرحيم أن رحمة الله واسعة وأنها واصلة إلى الخلق وهذا هو ما أومى إليه بعضهم أو بعضهم بقوله الرحمن رحمة عامة والرحيم رحمة خاصة بالمؤمنين. So as I just mentioned, I will just translate it quickly, that the term رحمن الرحيم is an indication that Allah's mercy is abundant and that it is reaching every creation of Allah. And this is why some of them have said that Ar-Rahman is general and Ar-Rahim is specific for the believers. وَلَمَّا كَانَتْ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ لِكَافِ الرَّحْمَةِ خَاصَةِ فِي الدُّنْيَا فَقَطْ فَكَأَنَّهَا لَا رَحْمَةُ اللَّهُمْ سبحان الله. And when the mercy for the believer, for the kafir, I'm sorry, is a mercy that is only يعني conditional to the world with this dunya, meaning now while they have it, it is almost as if it is not a source of rahmah for them. لأنهم في الآخرة يقول عليكم السلام لأنهم في الآخرة يقول تعالى لهم إذا سألوا الله أن يخرجهم من النار وتوسلوا إلى الله تعالى بربوبيته واعترافهم على أنفسهم ربنا أخرجنا منها فإن عدنا فإنا ظالمون فلا تدركهم الرحمة بل يدركهم العدل فيقول الله عز وجل لهم قال اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون. He says because on the day of judgment when the disbelievers will ask Allah عز وجل to remove them from the fire and they will beg him by confessing and admitting to his lordship and by confessing against themselves regarding their sins and disbelief, they will say, our Lord, take us out. Verily, if we return, we are among the oppressors. He said the mercy will not reach them then. Rather, it will only be justice. Allah Azza wa Jal says to them, اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون. Allah says, remain in it, and you shall not speak to me. Now, the scholars say, I remember reading in the tafsir, this is one of the most severe verses in the Quran, believe it or not. This one, and the one in Surah An-Naba. فَذُوقُوا فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ إِلَّا عَذَابًا. So taste, we will not increase you except in punishment. And this one here is one of the most severe verses in the Quran. Why? Because it is the ultimate loss. When Allah the Most Merciful, the one whom all the mercy that we are using on earth right now, from the mother caring for her children and us being merciful to one another, is only one part of 99, one part of 100. And the other 99 Allah has saved for the day of judgment to show His mercy to the people. And all these qualities of Allah, for a person to be said or to be told on the day of judgment while he's in the fire by Allah, remain in there and do not speak to me, this is the worst thing that could ever happen. If no one is more merciful than Allah, so the most merciful, you lost his mercy. This is agony of the soul. This is different than the punishment of the physical punishment. This is mental punishment. I mean, you understand the feeling? May Allah never give us this feeling. These are people who will be eternally in hellfire. And there's absolutely no changing for their condition. And they are asking Allah and begging Him that we have admitted. Now, take us out. We will not go back. We will not be among the... Allah says, do not speak to me. Ajeeb, this is yani... Allah musta'an. This is severe. And they will have no other option.
The tafsir is in Surah... Which one?
This is Surah Al-Mu'minun, verse 108. طيب. قوله الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. This is the statement of Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. Praise be to Allah who sent His messenger with the guidance and the religion of truth, and we will see what is meant by that. In order to in order to ليظهره على دين كله, in order to have it overpower or dominate all of the other religions, and Allah is sufficient as a witness to that. Now the Shaykh will explain that. Allah تعالى يحمد على كماله عز وجل وعلى إنعامه. Allah عز وجل is praised for His perfection and for His generosity and the things that He bestows upon us. فنحن نحمد الله عز وجل لأنه كامل الصفات من كل وجه. So we praise Allah عز وجل because He is perfect in His attributes in every sense, in every sense of the word. ونحمده أيضا لأنه كامل الإنعام والإحسان. And we also praise Him because He is perfect in His bounty and His generosity towards His creation. Allah says, وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله ثم إذا مسكم الضر فإليه تجأرون. سورة النحل, verse 53, Allah says, and there isn't a bounty, there isn't a single bounty except that it is from Allah. Nothing, even يعني, the breath that we are breathing right now, this is a ni'mah from Allah. If Allah willed, you cannot breathe anymore. And no doctor, no hospital, no nothing can do absolutely anything for you. It doesn't matter how fancy they are and how famous they are. If Allah wants to prevent you from breathing or from your heart, from pumping, it's a hopeless case for the whole creation, all of them together. So this is a ni'mah. Of course, we're heedless sometimes, may Allah Azza wa Jal rectify us. But every ni'mah is from Allah. And then if harm touches upon you, and when harm touches upon you, to Allah you start crying for help. And this is how the son of Adam is, as Allah tells us about the disbelievers, while they're in the ship, and everything is cool, it's nice sail, nothing. They're associated upon us with Allah. As soon as some wind comes, and they are in this, they're about to be drowned, and it's a tornado or what have you, then they start begging Allah and worshiping Allah. Then they call unto Allah alone, and they don't associate no partners with them. Then when Allah saves them to the land and they're back in safety, they go back to shirk. And anyways, وأكبر نعمة أنعم الله بها على الخلق إرسال الرسل الذي به هداية الخلق. ولهذا يقول مؤلف الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق. He says, and the biggest bounty, the ultimate bounty that Allah has bestowed upon the creation is sending the messengers. Sending the messengers in order to guide mankind and the creation. In order to guide mankind. Now of course we know the biggest bounty is Islam. But how did you get Islam? Through Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the asl is the messenger. And who sent the messenger? Allah. So it's all connected. This is why the Mu'allif, the author of the book, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, said, praise be to Allah who sent the messenger. Who sent the messenger with the guidance and the religion of truth. والمراد بالرسول هنا الجنس. And what is intended here by prophet or messenger is the general meaning. Okay? فَإِنَّ جَمِيعَ الرُّسُلُ أُرْسِلُوا بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ ولكن الذي أكمل الله به الرسالة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Here we're speaking about the term messenger is general. Yet we are speaking particularly about one, الرسول. Yes, he says because all of the messengers came in order to guide the people into the truth. But the one whom Allah has completed the message with is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فإنه قد ختم الله به الأنبياء وتم به البناء. Verily Allah has sealed the prophets, all prophets with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah has completed the construction with him as well. كما وصف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نفسه بالنسبة للرسل. كرجل بنى قصرا وأتمه إلا موضع لبنة. فكان الناس يأتون إلى هذا القصر ويتعجبون منه إلا موضع هذه اللبنة. يقول فأنا اللبنة وأنا خاتم النبيين عليه الصلاة والسلام. He says, just as the Prophet ﷺ described himself in comparison to the other messengers. He said, verily, my example according in comparison to the other messengers is like a man who built a castle and he perfected it. Except for one corner, one part of it, which was missing one stone. One stone. And the people will come And they say, this is a beautiful castle, man, except for this.